And Adam gave names to all the cattle and the fowls of the air and every beast of the field. For Adam, there was not found a helpmate for him. Now, the tree of life was good for food, and it was pleasant to the eye. And so we're going to take a look at why. Why didn't they go to the tree of life? If they'd gone to the tree of life, what would have happened? They'd have lived forever. They wouldn't have had to worry about sin, huh?
That's right.
And Adam said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She should be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and they were not ashamed. Well, question, another question, why would God knowingly allow Satan, the tempter, and the creator of evil to have access to Adam and Eve, whom he created in his own image? God had created all the animals, Adam and Eve, on the sixth day. He created the animals first. Adam and Eve were the crown of creation. Now, God could have created Eve right out of the dust like he did Adam. God did the first divine institution in mind, and that was the institution of marriage. Man gives life to the woman, and the woman gives life to the world. Now, Adam and Eve were the only two people that ever existed that had no mother. They had no mother. In fact, with Adam and Eve, there was a whole lot of firsts there. They were the very first people to ever get evicted. God gave marriage as a gift to Adam and Eve. He made them perfect for each other. Man was to leave his parents. Of course, he didn't have mother. He had God. He was to be the head of his wife. He was to instruct her, to love her, protect her. She was to love and respect and obey him. They were to raise up children and teach them to love, reverence, and obey God first. And then them also. Turn to Ephesians chapter 5. In Ephesians chapter 5, we start verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of the body. Or is the church itself in Christ? So let the wives be their own husbands and everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church. He gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that he should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourish and cherish it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. They become one flesh in childbearing, when the man's sperm and the woman's egg come together, and they create a new DNA. Now, this is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you, in particular, so love his wife, even as himself. And the wife, see that she reverence her husband. So, another verse, 1 through 4. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment. That it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. And your fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them to the nurture and admonition of the Lord. You know, if we were doing that today, while that was being done in America, we wouldn't be in a condition we're in.
Amen.
Today, America is hurting. Going back to where we left off. chapter 2. And in chapter 2, and verse 25. And they were both naked, and a man and his wife were not ashamed. But sometimes you'll notice little children will run outside naked. They get on the bathtub or something, and they're out in the yard, and they're naked. But they're not ashamed because they're innocent.
Yeah.
But here, this summer, during the Republican convention, you're supposed to have 100 women that come down and get stark naked down there in Cleveland. They did that a few years back. Okay? And they're going to run out there, and they won't be ashamed either. Okay, and the reason is your conscience is seared.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be out there and be stark naked because they're whores. And that's what God put in the Bible calls them. Okay? And out there with those whores will be whoremongers. You can bet. For every naked woman, there'll probably be 20 naked guys out there watching. Okay? Not naked, the men will be naked. But they'll be watching the women. Okay? And that's there at the Republican Party convention. And I'm not sure what their goal is. I never could figure that out. Often when we were out at the abortion mills, missionaries to the unborn, out preaching in front of the abortion mills, when we would have sit-ins, a bunch of these women from now would come out. They'd come out topless, okay? And somehow, by them coming topless, that was supposed to discourage us or something, okay? I've never really found out what it is, but the interesting thing, they don't have, their conscience doesn't bother them because their conscience has been seared. And, you know, in the Greek, the word conscience, the word ton means with. Chitz means the science. It's science. It's con science. And the word science means knowledge. It means with knowledge. A conscience gives you knowledge. And these people that have lost their conscience of this here, they're totally without any knowledge. They become to the point where they're reprobate. And starting over in Genesis chapter 3, now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God made. And he said unto the woman, yea, have God said, now listen to this. Listen to what he's doing. This is something that's done today. The media is perfect at this. They'll turn things around away from what you're saying. Okay? Just like the focus. When you get this term pro-choice. Now what was the whole purpose of this where it comes to abortion? Well, I sat down with some of the former abortion leaders, and they said they came up with the language of illusion to take the focus off the fact that during abortion, the baby dies. So we had to take that focus off the fact that the baby dies and put it on a woman's privacy. So they created something that wasn't there, okay? That you have, and they created a right in the Constitution that's not there. How many of you read the Constitution? Have you ever seen in that, or in the Bill of Rights? Now you have seen the Bill of Rights where it gives us the right to life, liberty, and freedom, right?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever seen anywhere where it mentions the right to abortion, the right to kill your child, or even the right of privacy? You go on and says, now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made, and he said unto the woman, yea, as God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. God said, of all the trees you can eat but one tree. God didn't say, you can't eat of every tree of the garden. Okay. And the woman said unto the serpent, you may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Well, what did he change up here? He changed the word. Okay? God said, surely, you will surely die. Now, the word surely die means what?
Well.
It means you're going to die. You're going to be real temperature, okay? But he changed that to less. And that means what? That means possibly the problem. maybe, okay. Now, God never told Eve not to eat of the fruit. That was pretty a good knowledge. He told Adam. Adam's job was to do what? To make sure that Eve understood that, right? So, again, the question, why did Eve change surely to the last? They were meant to live forever. The tree of life was the most pleasant to the eye. Why didn't they eat of the first? If they would have eaten of the tree of life first, then they would have lived forever. Right? And it was the most pleasant looking of all the trees. So why didn't they go to the tree of life? And we'll get to that. And then why did Adam listen to his wife instead of God? You know what? See, God gave Adam a charge, all right? And when you get a charge of something, that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to take responsibility. When men don't take responsibility, then bad things happen, right? But we have some examples. It was a fellow named Abraham, remember? And he had a wife named Sarah. And he knew better. God told Abraham, listen, don't worry about it. Sarah's going to have a baby. But Sarah told Abraham, if you listen here to me, I'm going to give you Hagar, okay? So what did he do? Well, Sarah was a beautiful woman. He hearkened to his wife. What happened? We got today. Well, you got Saudi Arabia. Remember what it says in Genesis 16? That Ishmael, his hand will be against every man and every man's hand against him. Nobody kills as many Muslims as